This guided meditation is different to others you may have experienced. It is passive, not active. You will not be asked to go on a journey to a different place. In this guided meditation, based on old principles of indigenous peoples, the place you wish to visit will come to you. You will not travel, you will experience. You will not imagine, you will know. Be still. And let what you hear envelop you. Everything journeys in circles. Nothing truly has a beginning, and nothing truly has an end. When we are born, we bring with us an echo of another past. When we think, we incorporate into our thoughts the visions and hopes of another future. Great mystery is eternal, and we too have a never-ending existence. When we do that which is bad, our negative actions may follow in our wake for many generations. When we do good, we may make the lives of future generations blessed. Some say that we cannot know our past. Some say that we cannot perceive our future. It is true that we are not allowed to know everything that we have done and everything we will do. Only great mystery knows all. However, Creator has given us the ability and the intelligence to engineer our actions. If we wish to do good, we can. Only our weaknesses prevent us. To lead a life that is truly noble and truly good, we need to get connected. We need to connect with Mother Earth and Father Sky. We need to touch the heart of Grandmother Moon and welcome the warmth of Grandfather Sun. By getting connected, we receive wisdom, and wisdom allows us to lead lives that will bring real blessings to others. It also allows us to bring peace into our own heart and experience a joyous and spirit-filled existence. The music and words on this CD are designed to help you get connected. There are seven sacred directions. The East is the place of enlightenment and understanding. As the sun rises in the East and reveals the beauty and majesty of the earth, so too does great mystery enlighten our hearts and minds to wondrous truths. The South is the place of beginnings. Here we begin our medicine walk. Here we see the grass begin to grow. Here we see newborn infants arrive into the world and new ideas grace our consciousness. The West is for the earth. Here we may find answers to our most pressing corporeal difficulties. Darkness is in the West, and so is sleep. The bear spirit lives in the West and guards our dream lodge. In the West, we find quiet. The North is the future. It is the home of the buffalo and the ice spirits. The North is the place of knowledge and the intellect, the place where answers can be found if we search for them with respect. The above is the place of the spirits. With training, we can learn how to journey to the above. Here, we may gain insight and wisdom from those who have walked this walk many times before us. The below is also a place of spirit. With proper training, we may journey here too. Here, for instance, we may meet the spirits of our animal friends and ask them for knowledge. When the shaman journeys to the below, he or she finds it filled with wonder and mystery. The final sacred direction is the within. You cannot find the within on a compass, for it lies deep within the heart. It is to the within we journey when we want to find the stillness. It is to the within we journey when we wish to leave behind the cares of this mundane world and connect with the Creator. A wise old Indian once taught me that it is easy for a man to travel to the east, the south, the west, and the north by walking. We can also journey above in an airplane, or below by entering a tunnel under the ground. However, to journey to these directions with the spirit is not so easy. We need to get connected. And to get connected, we need to be still. The best way to still the spirit is by sitting upon the ground. Some like to feel Mother Earth beneath them, whilst others like to sit upon a medicine blanket. In truth, it does not matter. What matters is that we open our hearts and minds to great mystery. That we welcome as our own the rest of the creation. When you sit upon the ground, you should breathe deeply. Let the air fill your lungs and invigorate you. The wind is a gift from Wiji Manitou, the great mystery. Touch the wind. And let the wind touch you. Be happy, for now you are discovering what it is like to be still. Once I was meditating upon my blanket, and the wind spirits gave me a wondrous gift. They allowed me to hear the leaves and the trees caress each other gently. I listened as they whispered to each other. Then they started to talk to me. From the leaves on the trees, I learned the art of gentle speech. I learned the importance of being kind and the value of being patient. Indeed, all creation speaks to us like this. All we need to do is listen. And all we need to listen is to be still. When we sit upon the earth or the medicine blanket, we need to remember the importance of giving thanks. Great mystery is our friend. The grandfathers are our friends. The walking things are our friends. The swimming things are our friends. The flying things are our friends. The trees, the plants, the rivers, the clouds, the lightning, the thunder. All of these things are our friends. Truly, all creation is our friend. And we need to be a friend to all of the creation. Who does not thank a friend for a gift or express gratitude to a companion for an act of kindness? When you are still, lift up your hands and hold them out in front of you with your palms upwards. In this way, you can express confidence that great mystery will supply everything you need to live. In this way, you also offer a gift in return. You see, within your hands lies your heart, a heart filled with love and blessings. As you give, so do you receive. I have heard it said that it is wrong to speak to the spirits, that the Creator becomes angry if we attempt to talk with the grandfathers. I do not believe this. Great mystery is like a father to me, and the grandfathers are like older brothers and sisters. It is a strange brother or sister who does not wish for their younger sibling to talk with them. When you are still, and after you have offered thanks, open your heart to the spirits. Tell them of your hopes and fears, your desires and longings, your problems and worries, your tears and your laughter. Do not become distressed if they do not answer you immediately. Be content in the knowledge that they have heard you, and in the fullness of time, you will receive an answer. One day on the reservation, I was bitten by an insect and was in great pain. Spirit Weaver would always walk barefoot, and I was puzzled at this. Was she not afraid that she would get bitten too? I was later told by a shaman that we are not important, and so, if we are not important, then the bite we get bitten with cannot be that important either. When we become still It is good not to think of ourselves as important. We should always pray for others before ourselves. We should not ask for money unless it is to relieve the poverty of another. We should not ask for food unless by eating we strengthen ourselves to do that which Wijimanitu wishes us to do. We should not ask for comfort unless by being comfortable we can think more clearly. When you are still, upon the blanket, offer a prayer to the Creator. Thank the Creator for making you unimportant. Bless Great Mystery for your lowliness. In this life, it is not important for a man to be famous or well-received. What is important is that you have a pure heart. It is hard to become still when our thoughts are focused on riches and fame. When our journey northward ends and we enter the spirit world, no one will be interested if, in this life, we rule a nation or accumulated a fortune. The grandfathers would rather see a clean heart than a hoard of silver or gold. The world is filled with sad people. Sadness may be caused by adverse conditions, fear of the future, or a sense of hopelessness regarding the present. Mostly, however, we get sad because of the actions of others. When we are sad, we need to unburden ourselves. We may wish to speak to a trusted friend. And this is good. However, prayer to the Creator is far more effective. Because Great Mystery knows our hearts better than we know them ourselves, there is no need to hide anything. We can tell the Creator all. When we learn to do this, the attitudes and reactions of others become less important. Sometimes sadness makes us cynical. We begin to doubt that there are truly good people around us. Praying to the Creator helps us regain our perspective. If we look for the good in others, we will find it. We may not find perfection, but we will find sincerity and good intentions. Focus on the goodness you see in others and reflect it back upon them. Some time ago, my youngest son had a parakeet. The bird was like one of the family. One day, I was very sad because my father-in-law had died, and I had loved him dearly. The bird, who had never paid me much attention, picked a grape from a bowl, flew over, and placed it in my mouth. I was amazed at this. The bird knew that I was sad and, in its own way, was trying to lighten my burden. Till the day that little bird died, I loved it with all my heart. I learned a great lesson from this. The lesson I learned was that we do not need fellow humans to make us happy. To many people, happiness can only be gained by the accumulation of possessions. The Indian does not think like this. To the Indian, happiness comes by getting connected. $100 will not help me talk to the spirits. $1,000 will not give me an easy medicine walk. $100,000 will not help me appreciate the blessing of a good wife. $500,000 will not bring my ancestor back. $1,000,000 will not help me see if I lose my eyes. I have learned in this life that money cannot make a person happy. One can drown just as easily in money as one can drown in water. If you seek true happiness, get connected. As you walk through life, it is good to continually re-examine our values and perceptions. Abandon those that are of little or no value. Embrace those that will enhance your own life and the lives of others. Take time out every day to meditate and contemplate. These things I know. You may never be rich or famous. You may never rule nations or have great influence. But what you will have is peace of mind and a wonderful connection to the rest of the creation. Gifts such as these are priceless.